Where's Sam? It's time for a little Jocktober before we get too far away from sports. We got other great stories today, too. The plane fucking story we'll get into. Holy shit.
Yeah.
We'll save that one for Patrice, who will be here very shortly.
He cheeky.
Here comes Sam running down the hall. Jocktober.
Oh, damn it. I missed his funny feet.
I'm too quick.
Yeah.
Sam, what's up, buddy?
Not too much.
We're taking a little different approach with Jocktober today, right?
That's right. I spent yesterday listening to various hit music stations, and everyone's got baseball fever.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Baseball fever.
That's right.
How are they expressing their baseball fever?
Well, all our friends in radio, our coworkers.
Could you do this when you say friends?
All our friends and coworkers in radio.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They have their own parody songs that they're playing on their stations like every half hour or something. Like they're playing them all the time.
Because they think they're really good.
They like them.
Remember the famous one when we were at NEW, the...
Hey, Joey Baseball.
Yeah.
How you doing, man? Hey, not for nothing. How great are the Yankees doing?
Oh, forget about it. How you doing? What a year it's been. My boy Charlotte's called. He wants us to do a little something special for the fellas.
Yeah, wait a minute. This little ditty we're going to sing right now?
Where do you hear this?
This is like 10 years ago.
When you talk baseball songs, this is right up there with the Super Bowl shuffle.
That's it.
The pinstripes, 35 American League pennants, 24 World Championships, on the drive for 25, how you doing?
Yeah, playing in the Bronx, in the house that Roots built, in New York City, the greatest city in the world, how you doing? How about the legends?
The Bay. The Iron Horse.
The reason the rest of the country hates New Yorkers is because of that type of that voice.
Mickey Mantle. How you doing? Not for nothing. What's with the big shots with the cell phones and the suits? Please. Give me the bleacher creatures any day. How you doing?
That's right.
I'm an ooch. The other day I'm on a 4 train. There's a guy sleeping next to me. He's got Yankee tickets sticking out of his pocket. How you doing?
Yeah.
Here's more. Huh?
This song was huge 10 years ago.
Yeah,
huge.
Whitey, Reggie, Louisiana Lakers.
Plus, they kept redoing it every season for a while.
You've got the Giants, you've got the Jets, you've got half of Ellis Island. Hey, Jersey, can we keep the Yankees? How you doing?
Hey, man. Oh, chop this. There's only one team in the 90s. The Yankees. So how you doing?
Yeah, then it goes with all the current players of the Yankees that year. So we fade it out here. You want to hear more? How you doing?
I mean, I like this song a lot.
Yeah, I'll pop it back up for the big closer.
Joe Bulls, you got the tickets?
No, I don't got the tickets. You got the tickets.
No, I don't have the tickets. You don't let me carry them no more. Don't you remember? Game 6, 96, I lost them.
Oh, that's right. I could have killed you. All right, I got the tickets.
How you doing?
How you doing?
What jersey you going to wear? I don't know. I'm thinking about wearing my Gita jersey. The only problem is the girls don't leave me alone.
My Knobloch jersey's dirty. My Jimmy Ravis is dirty. My Soho is a mess.
Oh, why don't you wear Coney's jersey?
Are you nuts? He's pitching tomorrow.
I don't know. What are you going to do?
What am I going to do? I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to wear the Urabu. How are you doing?
Let's get going, man. The car's ready.
No. We're not driving the Yankee Stadium.
Why not?
Because to get there, we got to drive by that purple stadium.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Hold on. You know, watch out for how we're going to get there.
Let me tell you something.
I just bought 2 Metro cards. How you doing?
Metro cards.
Going local with the Metro card thing. One question right off the bat. Were they going for the laugh? I don't know. Were they going for a laugh there? For real?
I don't think so. I don't know what to think. I'm stunned.
I believe they were trying to create an anthem, and they were successful in that.
I'm stunned by that whole thing. To me, that is to Italians what eat that watermelon or whatever that.
Eat that. Well, yeah.
But
that song, I think, was embraced by
everyone.
The Yankee organization, because I think they actually played it at games.
Yeah, they played it in a stadium.
You know, your team that doesn't like all that gimmicky stuff, I do believe they might have embraced that song for a while.
Gimmicky stuff is one thing. Horrid songs.
I think that was played at Yankee Stadium, but I'm not sure. We're going to have to get a hardcore fan to call in and let us know. Did they play that at the stadium, man? Do you know?
Yeah, I do remember them playing at least a piece of that.
How you doing?
How you doing?
Eat that watermelon, eat that watermelon, eat that watermelon. Surely it's good. Eat that watermelon, eat that watermelon, eat that watermelon. Surely it's good.
And they all eat watermelon, too.
No.
Eat that watermelon, eat that watermelon.
No, they don't?
That is exactly what that was as far as, like, Italian goes.
How you
Yay! Hey, Kamanooch!
We got Dan in Philly. Dan.
Wow.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Pretty good, Dan.
I've been hearing you talk about douche chills for a couple years now, and I think I just had my first one.
Now you know what it is.
Are you a Phillies fan?
I know you are. I'm a Phillies fan. You got it.
I asked that because we went back, because that's a classic. Classic awfulness, the Yankees How You Doing song.
Yeah, you can tell by the
we're about to play a brand new one by a radio station down in Philly, my friend. So
yeah.
So let's measure the douche chills and see if they get worse as we move on here. Because that one was actually embraced by a lot of people.
Oh. Yeah. Hit Radio in Philly, they like their baseball team.
Really, Sam? Really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Well, why don't we start with the first one? It's Jocktober 09, bad radio in New York and Philly. They all have baseball fever.
That's right.
And we go down to Philly, a little station called Q102. It's like one of their hit music stations down there.
Yeah, it's a big top 40 station. Mm. It's like their version of Z100.
Right. Is that the one with that fucking douchebag that made fun of the cop shootings down in Philly?
I'm not sure.
Someone from Philly let me know, because I'll never forget that fucking douchebag. His cue of the D was something about how many cops were shot this month in Philly, and they had a big laugh over that. Mm. Fucking assholes. Q102's Philly's going all the way to the tune of Miley Cyrus' Party in the USA.
What? You get it? Party in the USA.
I don't even know the original song, so maybe Travis could give us a little taste. Miley Cyrus, Party in the USA. Do we know that song?
It's a big hit song right now.
I couldn't fucking tell you.
Really?
No. Oh, my God.
It's placed very high on the top 20 on 20.
All right, here it is. A little piece. This is the original song, and then we'll play the Phillies Going All the Way.
I hopped up the plane at LAX.
Oh,
of
course you have.
You've heard this?
Yes.
How?
I leave my house.
It's a big, big song.
I leave my house? I never heard this. Where do you hear this?
Serious Hits 1.
Where do you hear this?
Honestly, at Jubilee, if you really need to know, my fucking grocery store plays the morning mashup.
How do you know who this is?
Even I didn't know it was Miley Cyrus.
Oh.
I just heard this fucking song.
There's no shame in it. You can enjoy it. I do. just admit to it and you're good.
Lots of shame in it.
Not on this end.
All right. All right, enough.
Oh.
So
Q102
took that song and turned it into Philly's Going All the Way.
That's correct.
And Tulowitzki is down on strikes. Brad Lidge does it again. And the Philadelphia Phillies are headed to the NLCS.
Hop off the plane, we in PHI. This is a baseball town, painted red in the sky. We on a playoff bus, round one is finished. And we ain't stopping till we're done, so we gotta come with it. The fans built to the top, fans ready to rock. We taking the mound, strike one out the box. A couple more till the final score reads the chance. Repeat city till the broad street's ready to dance. Another parade in the stands, the world better make way. Philadelphia's dedication to HK. Make them proud with the swing of a bat. Citizen Bank's only place where the Phillies be at. It's like that, getting close with an eye on the prize. Either LA or NY won't survive. We built for this, second time on the attack. The World Series, here we come, Philadelphia's back.
So I put my hands up, damn, it's coming on.
Sends one to right. Can Ugly score?
Wow.
Nice.
I've been to a few. I've been to, I think, three Phillies games this past year. It's mostly a white crowd. So why are they going with, like, kind of an urban feel for their for their song?
It's what the kids are listening to.
Nice to see they f***ed it all up.
Okay.
Well, they did. Flying Hawaiian, someone ring the bell, worth it, it never fell. The seas for a piece
of a story to tell. About the time that stairs had him yelling, it sounded in. You don't like that song?
I don't think the white boys in Philly are cranking this one up there, Sam.
Well, the black guys aren't doing it either. It's very, I mean, there's no, no hip-hop guy is going to play a Miley Cyrus parody. So maybe they missed it.
Hold on.
So you guys didn't like that one?
No, Sam.
I hate it.
Really?
I hate that.
Oh, no.
This is going to be rough.
Horrible. The Phillies go, it's not Party in the USA. It's Phillies going all the way.
Gang, gang, gang.
Gang, gang, gang.
Yes.
Doesn't mean you have to make a whole song about it just because one part of the song kind of fits.
I guess I could just do the hook.
Yeah, Jay in D.C. Jay.
Hey, what's up, guys?
What's up?
Just saying, that is the worst piece of shit I've ever heard.
I love how it gets people angry.
It's horrible, man. It's thanks to people like Miley Cyrus, which has ruined popular music. The 90s used to rock, and now thanks to these little whiny bitches, music sucks now.
The 90s had their boy bands. I don't know what you're talking about.
Was, if you're talking pop music, the 90s was a rough time for pop music.
Well,
all the boy band crap.
No, man,
half of them were homosexuals.
I don't know.
Singing to the young girls, and the young girls had no idea that they were listening to homosexuals.
Lance Bass.
Thank you, sir. Let's go to... Ah, fuck it. Let's go to the next song.
Okay.
So then we move back to New York, because it's looking like a Philly fucking New York thing, right?
Exactly.
Our old radio station, which is now called what?
92.3 Now.
Oh, all right.
That's... Say goodbye to Opie and Anthony. They were then. This is now.
Well, they're really getting the job done, aren't they?
Yes, they are.
I haven't heard fucking nothing about that station.
I was listening.
I see a van every once in a while at a sporting event.
I was listening.
And you know what? Sorry, I don't mean to babble, but when you go to a sporting event, you see all the radio stations lined up with their shit they want to give you, which is all just crap.
Yeah.
And, you know, some of the New York stations do very well in those situations, and they got a nice crowd around their dumb van, right? This fucking Now station, they sit there with their hands in their pocket. No one cares enough to get free shit from this this station.
I was listening to them yesterday, and one of the commercials was a commercial telling you to advertise on radio. That's where they're at.
Not a good sign.
Oh. And it's commercial free Mondays. Oh. I haven't heard any commercials in overnight. So I was listening on the drive in this morning, and there was no commercials on.
That could be a problem.
They also
a good move, huh, boys?
No morning show, no overnight jock.
Yeah, they replaced us. They replaced us basically with nothing.
Well, Chunky is there,
but not in the morning.
No, he's in the afternoons tearing it up. No, actually, evenings tearing it up.
Really?
Yes.
How many people they got following them on their Twitter page?
Over 2,500.
For a radio station.
Oh, no.
Almost 2,500.
Almost.
2,500 people for a whole radio station?
Over 2,200. Danny's right to correct me.
Fucking assholes. Yeah, you guys know what you're doing in management.
Good job.
Fucking losers.
But remember their song, I'm in New Jersey, bitch. We played it on this show. No recollection from either.
What song? Is it a real song?
No, it was like a parody of I'm in Miami, bitch, but it's I'm in New Jersey, bitch.
It's coming back to me now. Yeah.
Well, this guy, his name's Faux Onassis, and obviously they just have him do
What's his fucking legal name?
No, I think that is it. Faux Onassis.
His mom said, I'm going to name my kid Faux what?
Faux Onassis.
No, that's not his real name.
There's an apostrophe in it.
Really? Yeah. I want to see his driver's license.
Well, I don't have it, but...
What does it say in his driver's license?
Faux Onassis?
Probably Tom fucking King.
But the thing is, he did this one too, so obviously They just get Phone Asses as their go-to guy.
All right.
for a good parody song.
Well, there's a bunch of Yankees songs this year, and this is one that's trying to become the song as the Yankees try to
win this
World Series thing.
They're all trying to be the next "How You Doing?"
How you doing?
And 92.3 Now is literally playing this. I got a text that said, "You gotta grab this song. I just heard about it." I put on 92.3 Now, and I only had to wait 15 minutes before the song came on. It's on all the time.
The Flea wants in. The Flea.
Yeah, hey, what's up?
What's up, Flea?
I just wanted to tell Anthony, I tried to call him about this a couple days ago. My sister just showed me the Miley Cyrus video for that song, the Party of the USA thing.
Yeah.
It should be illegal. I thought Anthony would really, really like it.
Well, cue that up, Dan.
It's basically like a 16-year-old chick with her. She's basically dancing around in her underwear. I thought you would really, really like
that. Oh. Well, you thought correct, sir.
And maybe you could invite her over and hide her in your closet.
And Miley's one of these Disney girls, right?
Not anymore, really.
Yeah, no, well,
she's out.
Who's she work for now, corporate-wise?
I mean, she's doing her own thing. She's got some record label behind her.
Her pimp, her father.
Jesus, her fucking cut-off shorts are right up to where the lips start.
That's what I'm talking about. She works for the same porn company.
And she walks around like she's early 20s, but how old is she now? I mean, maybe 16, 17 finally?
Yeah, she's probably around 17.
Yeah.
She's fine now. Totally legal in New York.
Well, she works for the same parent company as Steve Phillips, so, you know, it's all good.
It's all good.
Look at that. Yeah, she's got little fucking
she's
shorts
right.
on.
Anyway.
Fuck, I didn't mean to do that, but I thought you were done.
Wow.
All right, why don't we go to the first Yankee song, trying to become the song.
Tic Tac and the Freak Show was playing this yesterday afternoon.
Who the fuck are they?
Tic Tac and the Freak Show.
Tic Tac and...
Who the fuck is Tic Tac and the Freak Show?
That's the afternoon,
you know,
guys.
I'm noticing
but you
something.
Can't call yourself the Freak Show when regular radio won't let you do anything.
Yeah, how freaky are they
getting?
Yeah,
what's the freakiest Freak Show gets?
Well, the big advertisement yesterday, the big texting thing, because they always want you... 92.3 Now is all about having you text them. If you text Tic Tac and the Freak Show yesterday, he'll text you back with the link of how you can listen to this song. After they played it.
Sam, I'm trying to be a better listener for real.
Okay.
I don't know what happened. No, I'm not even trying to make a joke.
Okay.
What did you just try to say?
Well, Tic Tac and the Freak Show.
Right.
I still have you, right?
I understand that part.
Okay.
I still have you.
And I asked you the Freak Show. What does he do that's freaky that his name is Freak Show? And you're giving me an example, right?
Their big promotion yesterday was, since they were hyping up this faux Nasus Yankees song.
Okay.
He said he wants people to text him. That station is all about the texting.
Well, they're trying to be all involved with new media.
Right, and then in their
fucking asshole.
In their PowerPoint shows, they could say, we got 10,000 texts last week.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Yes.
But
to advertise.
You can't new media doesn't matter if your product is just shit.
Right, exactly.
It doesn't matter.
But so he said the big thing was if you text Tic Tac, he'll text you back with a link of where you can go to listen to the song that they're playing on the radio on your computer. And that would be the incentive to text.
I saw Opie get lost again.
near the end, actually.
I did too, yeah.
Near the end.
The incentive to text so you can listen on the computer to the song that you listen to on the radio.
That just seems like too much work.
But
why isn't the fucking Tic Tac Freak Show guy? Is it the same guy?
Tic Tac and the Freak Show.
So his first name is Tic Tac, his last name is the Freak Show?
No. His name is Tic Tac, and he is presenting the Freak Show.
Who's the Freak Show?
It's Tic Tac.
It is, right?
Yeah.
See, that's why I was making
his
joke.
His interns. I mean,
So he doesn't even really have an actual Freak Show?
No, he doesn't have much of a cast of characters. There's not a huge budget for the Freak Show.
And by the way,
Tic Tac is holding it down.
By the way, Coke Logic writes, 92.3 Now only has 531 more followers than me, and they're a radio station in a major market.
Well, not a major market. Actually, it would be the number one.
The number one.
The
market.
Major market.
Right. Yes.
Yeah.
All right, that's wonderful, Sam. So here's the song. Here come the Yankees.
By Phononasis. It's what? Not technically, it sounds like a ripoff of Jay-Z's Run This Town to me, but it's not technically a parody song.
It's not.
Is that the song where he's got 100 problems,
but the bitch ain't one?
No, you're thinking of 99 problems.
Oh, yeah. 99 problems, but the bitch ain't.
This is that Billy Joel song he redid?
No, that is, he right. didn't do a Billy Joel song. He did a song called Empire State of Mind.
Oh, I thought it was We Didn't Start the Motherfucking Fire,
no,
yo.
None of these songs that you just listed have anything to do with this Phononasis song.
Okay.
Yeah. Did Jay-Z ever pay little Annie Hall, or not Annie Hall, fucking little Annie for that fucking ripoff in that other song?
There's no ripoff. If
Hard Knock Life?
Yes, yeah, the Hard Knock Life. He sampled Hard Knock Life, and I'm sure whoever owns the rights to that music was paid in full.
They got paid?
I'm sure they did.
What about little Annie? Did she get a little piece?
I don't know.
Because that was a big hit song for Jay-Z.
I don't know if Annie...
Little Annie get a little piece so she can buy her little Uggs?
She probably did not own the rights to the music and therefore would not be... part of the profit.
Jay-Z's a ripoff artist.
He's not a ripoff artist.
Because I heard 99 Problems with the Bitch Ain't One was done by somebody else too.
The title is the same.
Of what?
Of another rap song.
This is from fucking Annie.
It's redoing
it. How is he getting paid to just play the Annie song?
He's not. He's sampling it.
No, I hear.
That isn't a sample.
This is Annie.
Listen.
I guess that's supposed to make it better.
No, because in Annie it was never that.
It wasn't.
No, there's never no bass line. There's no bass line.
He got paid big because he could add the.
It sounds like Vanilla Ice explaining how his riff was different than Queen.
No. Yeah.
Because Vanilla Ice actually ripped that off and didn't pay anybody. Jay-Z paid to sample.
How do you know?
Because he said it. I mean, Jay-Z would have been under serious lawsuits.
Why does he have to rip off the Annie song when he could just come up with an original song?
He has come up with many original songs.
I'm not a big fan of the sample there, Sam.
Why? That's how hip-hop started.
I think
that's
cheating.
More than a sample.
Hip-hop started with rapping over other people's records.
Sample is taking a beat from something. This is the whole song.
It's just the hook.
A lot of old artists that never got a lot of money are getting fucking ripped off these days.
Because they don't own their rights to their music. That's their problem.
I think there's a Tainted Love one now, right?
Oh, yeah. See, that was just that one
riff from Tainted Love.
Just that one little part.
Which is the entire hook for the song.
Yeah, that's like,
right, they sampled the hook.
The sun will come out tomorrow, but your bottom dollar that tomorrow, come what may, tomorrow.
That would be a good sample.
Well, it was tomorrow.
See, they couldn't do it because Jay-Z already did this.
Like, right. that's like using that.
He also sampled I'd Do Anything from Oliver.
Really?
That's a lesser-known song, but it's really good.
Too much Jay-Z info.
All right.
We gave you your time.
Thank you.
Enough with you and your dumb Jay-Z
fuck
thing.
Fuck him.
So our old station, which is... What is our old station now?
923. Exactly.
Oh, really?
Uh-oh.
Yes.
What'd I do?
Correct. Our old station is Now.
Now. Okay.
923 Now.
Here's their Yankee song. They're trying to shove down their listeners' throats. Here come the Yankees.
I want to take this time, tell my Yankee fans stand up. Goodbye, Tory. Hello, Girardi, ever. Now we got better. Added on to Sheriff. When CC's a bad deal, you better get your best beat up. All right. Please salute Alita. Because now Devin Jeter made a born again believer.
Now we can reach for the stars. Follow dreams in our hearts.
I don't know what they're saying.
You just missed. You're about to miss a really good line. My favorite.
I don't know what they're saying.
It's very hard
Sam.
To understand.
Filling hip hip. What would you say generally?
I would say hip hip Jorge.
Have you heard this song?
Oh my God! No way.
Jump all day, hip hip Jorge. Like the bay, Robin sick and no playing position number four. And Godzilla, and Deki Masui, our designated hitter. Let's go. What up, Loki Cabrera? You know it's over what we said. Mariano Rivera, word is gone. Drop the name bomb. That's an A bomb from A Rock.
Hear the rumble in the Bronx. Cause the whole wide world is waiting. Time to show them that they're not alone. Remember, we're behind you. Make noise for the Yankees. The Yankees. The Yankees. The Yankees.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
Make noise for the Yankees.
What happened to white music?
Corny.
It's gone.
You know, that's it for that one, Sam.
You're not going to... That's it?
Yeah, that's it for that one.
How about the stadium next to me was sold
all right.
to... What?
Anthony.
What?
You're getting carried away.
I think that would be a good one.
Oh, they ripped off You Spin Me Round. That's a big hit song now.
They didn't rip it off. It was sampled.
No, it's a ripoff, man.
No, they're...
If you're supposedly an artist, you know, you could, like, come up with some new shit.
But they do come up with new stuff, and then they also take old stuff...
It's not really coming up with new stuff when they're using the basic riff of a really popular song.
But they're bringing it to a new audience, a new generation of people who will now appreciate it.
Most of the people have no idea that... the You Spin Me Round song was, you know... You spin me right round, baby, round, like a baby, baby, round.
They're not into that nonsense.
Do we have that song? You tell me that people are listening to this song know that it's from an old song. They don't know.
Someone's saying meat spin. Meat spin me round. Meat spin me.
Well, that's the song that plays when you go there.
Oh, does it?
Why wouldn't it?
You guys should talk about this with Patrice. Patrice knows so many hip-hop songs that have been sampled and stuff that you thought was original turns out to be old school.
He blew my mind when he was doing that.
Yeah, he really knows a lot
about it. Oh, yeah, he did the one, You got what I
Yeah, but even so much other stuff. Man. Right. It's like every classic rap song.
Why does every fucking like song, just like those two songs we just listened to about the Phillies and the Yankees, it's all got to be some bad fucking hip-hop R&B shit with some caterwauling bitch in the background going through vocal aerobics. Shut it!
What the kids are listening to.
Nah, fuck that. Kids are listening to that. Wiggers, they call them. They call them fucking wiggers.
No.
Yes, they do.
No, not anymore.
Nah, fuck
running. They've all assimilated now.
What's they? The children, you mean?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's...
No, it's exactly what I mean. I wasn't making a
decision. They're all into hip-hop. Chris in Smithtown writes, definitely not as good as Vinny and the Jets.
Oh,
that's an old listener right there.
Vinny and the Jets. Well, nothing ever beat Let's Go Mets Go.
Well, that was a terrific one. That was terrific.
Let's Go Mets Go.
Larry King wants in. Larry!
Hey, guys. How important is being able to understand the lyrics?
Yeah, that's...
I mean, as long as you can understand the hook, you get the message.
Oh, it's not that I'm an old curmudgeon. I've always hated fucking hip-hop. I hate it!
Get with it.
No!
You don't like a little Biggie?
I hated hip-hop when I was
Biggie,
fucking...
Biggie.
The only hip-hop I ever liked... The only hip-hop I ever liked was fucking...
N.W.A.,
Eazy-E, fucking Ghetto Boys, because the shit was funny to listen to.
They just talked
about smacking hoes and fucking fuck the police.
Respect yourself.
It was funny to fucking listen to.
See, what the point we're trying to make, Sam, there was a time where these artists took a sample, but it was very slight.
You know, easy.
And added a little bit to the song. Now they're taking the entire fucking song.
But that's the way it started.
Eazy-E was cruising down the street in his 6'4", jocking the bitches and smacking the whores.
That's correct.
Hoes, actually. But
the whores.
That's what
Can we hear a little
doing.
Biggie? You got a little Biggie for everybody?
Biggie.
Yeah.
You don't like the Biggie?
You gotta like Biggie.
Biggie no, fucking I don't rules. Like Biggie.
Biggie Smalls make you shit your drawers.
That's right. Fucking Biggie.
No, I don't like Biggie.
That fucking Biggie will get the job done.
I don't like fucking Tupac.
You don't like
about
Tupac?
California?
No, that shit blows.
Incorrect.
All right, why don't we get back to the baseball song?
Correct.
Jocktober, we're featuring Bad Radio in New York and Philly as they have baseball fever. Now we got another Philly song from the same dumb station, Q102, down there in Philly. You know that song, I Got a Feeling?
Black Eyed Peas. Tonight's gonna be a good night. Right. You know.
Do you know that pop song?
I fucking whatever.
Why are you so unhappy?
I hate
you don't know that song?
This shit.
You don't hear pop music just
No, here and there?
I do.
You got to know this one.
Yeah.
Kind of gets you pumped for a new day.
Yeah, because you hear it starts building, then the hook comes in and it really starts going.
You should play this every morning, getting ready for that job.
This could be the new intro.
Do I hear an auto tuner?
A little bit.
A little bit.
Wow. Go figure that out.
Wait for it to kick in.
Yeah, it's going to be good. You're going to like it.
Does Fergie kick it in?
No. Fergie she comes in a little later.
Kicks it in with her giant toes.
Think of that build. It's building.
Yeah. Like, oh my God. Jump out that
sofa. It's no ting ting.
There's Fergie.
I know that. So that's the song that Q102 did another Philly song to. Anthony, they changed the Black Eyed Peas, I Got a Feeling into. Are you ready for this?
Uh-oh.
I Got a Feeling.
Oh. So they didn't change the title.
But they did, my friend. They did. They spell feeling. P-H-E-E-L-I-N-G.
Yes.
Oh,
like the Phillies.
The Phillies. Oh.
Is it the same song?
No.
All right.
Very different.
We got a feeling that this year's gonna be a good year. That this year's gonna
be a good year.
That this year's gonna be a repeat year. The Phillies. 2009's gonna be a good year. Yeah, 2009's gonna be a good year. Yeah, 2009's gonna be a repeat year. This year's our year. Let's live it up. Phil keeps on winning. Can't get enough. Go out and smash it. Like, oh my God. Jump off that sofa. It's the play.
For the Phillies.
Last year we ruled.
We're gonna win it again.
Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it and do it. Let's win again and do it and
win again
and do it. Do it. Do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's repeat the feeling. Cause this year's gonna be a good year. Yes, this year's gonna be a good year. Yes, this year's gonna be a repeat year. The Phillies.
I got turned off, Sam.
That's it?
Yeah, that's plenty. Goes on for
because they won last year.
That's plenty for everybody.
Repeat year, right?
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Let me say hi again
to Mac in Atlanta. Mac.
Hey, Mac.
What's up, Mac?
Yeah, I wanted to ask Anthony. I mean, when did he switch from beer to Haterade?
Oh, what is it?
Damn, I'm drinking Haterade.
I thought that bottle said Gatorade. Yeah, I was wrong.
There's a G on here. It's not an H. There would be a big H on my bottle with a light.
Somebody must have replaced it with some Haterade then.
Haterade.
You seem a bit on edge today. You all right there?
What's wrong? I can't stand this shit. There is just... It's shit.
Haterade is right. That caller was right on the money.
This guy wants to add to that song we just heard. Dano in Kentucky.
Morning, fellas.
Hey, Dano.
Hey, guys. I got a feeling this chill's going to be a douche chill.
Yeah, I got a feeling.
Let me go to Scott on Long Island. Scott.
Hey, boys. What's going on?
Hey, man.
Listen to that. This is going to be a good year song. I actually just threw up in my mouth.
Oh, no.
He's vomiting. The song is making people vomit.
I hope everyone's okay out there.
Hey, Danny, what was that Biggie Smalls thing?
It's one of my favorite Biggie Smalls lines of all time.
You like Biggie Smalls?
No.
You don't like Biggie Smalls? Come on.
I'm not into
the Notorious B.I.G.
My hip-hop roots are, like, stuck in the early 90s. I never got away from that stuff. But I thought this was, like, one of the best lines I've ever heard a rap artist have. It's, I got techniques dripping out my butt cheeks. I got to sleep on my stomach so I don't fuck up my sheets.
See, there's nothing that creative in white people music.
I think Javis has the actual.
So check it. I got techniques dripping out my butt cheeks. Sleep on my
my stomach so I don't fuck up my sheets.
It's just a great line.
Come on.
How can he not like Biggie?
Conjures up a lovely image, doesn't it?
How can he not like the Biggie? All right, we move back to New York.
His pants a lot.
It's October, bad radio in New York and Philly.
He doesn't want to mess
with you. I know. They have baseball fever. We go to Z100.
Yeah. Drip down his balls anyway and get on his sheets. If his techniques are dripping out his butt cheeks, I think
he's got so many.
Would take its toll, and it would drip down his nutsack and drip onto his sheets anyway.
At least
he's all right with a few droplets.
Are you speaking from personal experience? Maybe someone that you know, maybe?
It could be that techniques could drip out your butt cheeks, even if you're on your stomach.
He don't mind a few droplets. He just doesn't want that big-ass fucking
exactly.
horse
You don't want, like, all techniques all over his
exactly. Gotcha. He understands he's going to get a little techniques. He just doesn't want a lot of techniques
all, right.
all over.
Z100, what have they been up to lately, Sam?
Well,
another great regular radio station.
Yeah. Elvis Duran is still rock and rolling in the mornings.
Is he really?
He's making a lot of money. They're really syndicating his show out there. Like, and every station that he's on, like in Philly, I think he's on a station. He's on all over the place. And he's advertised.
What does he do that? He's on all over the place.
He plays some songs and phone prank phone call. I mean, it's
not allowed to do prank phone calls.
No, fake prank phone calls.
So if you hear prank phone calls on regular radio, please know that they're not allowed to do that anymore, and it's all set up. And
but like every station that he's on, the station on their website advertises it as if it's their exclusive morning show, like Philly's Elvis Duran or Cleveland's Elvis Duran. And it's like it's not. But yeah, they have a Yankee song. Apparently, this song is getting played in the stadium. But that's not going to stop us from herbing them up.
Well, of course.
Wait, this is being played at Yankee Stadium?
That's what E-Rock Nagel
So this has got to be really good.
You would think.
The Yankees wouldn't let shit in their stadium.
Well.
Is it?
How you doing made it to the Yankee Stadium, so.
This is done to the Jay-Z song, Run This Town.
Featuring Kanye West and Rihanna, of course.
Featuring who?
Kanye West and Rihanna?
Who's Kanye?
Kanye West. I think you know who he is. He's a very famous rapper producer.
What do
you
do?
He's done a lot of songs, both hits that he's produced and rapped on.
I know Rihanna got beat up.
She's also had a lot of hits.
She got beat up by an umbrella or something.
No, that was her hit song.
Oh.
She got beat up by Chris Brown, but she has a new song out called Russian Roulette.
You know what? I was reading about Chris Brown today in the paper, getting a little knowledge, and he's really pissed at Oprah.
Why is that?
Because he went on Oprah, and Oprah gave her the fucking, you know, what, the what is it? What degree? Ninth?
Fifth?
Fifth? Third degree? Third degree, let's go with.
Because
third degree burns are pretty bad, so I'm going to go with the third degree.
All right. Yeah, you give him the third degree.
So Oprah gave him the third degree on the whole Rihanna thing, and he couldn't believe it because they've done some charity shit together in Africa. Like Chris Brown helped her with the African school thing or something. So he's all pissed off at Oprah that Oprah didn't understand.
Why would Oprah understand?
Right, of course Oprah took the angle she should have taken.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I think Oprah wins. Whoever's battling Oprah wins. I think.
Why? He actually chipped in on Oprah's rape school
in Africa. It was set up to be that. Yeah,
I don't think they set it up to be an actual
they didn't
rape,
set
school.
Up for rape school.
No, they did not.
I don't think it was called Oprah's rape school.
Oh,
because they'd have a problem with admissions, I would think, to start with.
Okay, my mistake.
Yeah. All right. Well, Q10.
Z100.
Oh, they're the same fucking station.
Z100.
Z100.
And keep in mind, we're right in the middle of the 92.3 Now Z100 rivalry that's heating up New York City. Why are you yawning at that?
Because it's just incomprehensible, this whole thing. I can't take all of these songs.
Well, let's do Z100's Yankees Run This Town.
That's right.
Key pride is in the air.
Yeah.
Hear fan screams from everywhere.
Yeah.
We're addicted to the thrill.
I'm ready.
In some baseball love affair. Mess with them, you're going down. Got a problem, tell me now. Postseason is Yankees time. They're gonna run this town tonight. Yankees gonna run this town tonight.
Her voice is average at best. But I'm okay with the song so far. And the only reason I stop it because I know they're just going to ruin it with a lot of nonsense.
That's not
Rihanna. Is the nonsense coming up?
There's some rapping.
And Danny, did you say Rihanna had a lot of hits too?
I did.
Sam did.
Yeah, she's had a ton of hits.
Oh, but that's not the joke.
No.
See, it would be a double entendre thing. She had right. all the hits.
Hits. Yeah. No, I meant songs.
Then it would be funny. Oh, you meant songs?
Yeah. Sounding. I meant I was just being factual.
Why would you be factual when there's a joke there?
I wanted to make sure everybody was informed.
And you should have then said, yeah, I said that because I meant, you know, when she got hit a lot.
No, I didn't mean that.
Oh, yeah.
It's a little punchable. I love what when happened? They add in the players' names.
Well,
that's just the best. Yeah.
And you guys are making fun of Let's Go Mets Go. Come on, I'd rather hear that at this point.
You didn't like that song?
It just gets too, noisy. There's too much stuff going on.
It just goes to show you what a producer really does to rap songs. Because these stink. You can't understand a word they're saying. It's all fucking just...
I mean, these aren't professional rappers
talking
either.
Talking over each other.
Steven S. wants to know, who the fuck is Babe Roof? Do they really say Babe Roof?
I mean,
he did.
That's poetic license.
Babe Roof.
Babe Roof. There's no roof on Yankee Stadium.
No, there is not a roof on Yankee Stadium. But that's
Babe Roof.
That's poetic license. You're allowed to change words a little bit.
Yeah, but when you go for a fucking job interview, you can't say, I like Babe Roof. You're not going to get the job.
That's true.
Who the fuck is that?
That's a Babe Roof.
Oh, Babe on the roof.
There's two girls.
Hot Babe sunbathing on the roof.
On a roof. That's Babe Roof.
That's a Babe Roof for you. Looking very nice. All right, finally, we go to Scott and Todd. What the fuck have these two been up to since we last talked?
Well, we haven't talked about Scott and Todd in like a year. So I figured that they're doing some better stuff now.
Yeah.
And Ant, you wanted to hear what, like some white people parodies.
White people music, yes.
And thank God Todd Pettengale is around for you to give you some white person music parodies.
He is white.
The biggest hack.
You think so?
In all of Morning Zoos.
He used to host WWF Mania.
Yeah. Where did that get him?
I mean, he's back on the same morning show where he started.
Exactly.
So, in the exact same spot, except now he's not on TV anymore.
And he's still doing the show with Rocky Dennis?
No, that's Scott Shannon.
Rocky Dennis.
No, that's
I love when the blind, Scott. I love when the blind girl touched Scott Shannon's face.
Yeah.
You guys are getting the two
that
confused.
Was great.
Well, a guy shouldn't be getting fucking plastic surgery. Most people shouldn't be getting fucking plastic surgery.
He was supposed to go on a motorcycle tour of Europe with... Todd.
Really?
Yeah, and then Todd said he couldn't make it, and he pulled the pins out of the map and started crying, and then he went to sleep and died.
No, I just heard him on the air yesterday.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh.
I think you're confused with somebody else.
Sorry.
That's all right. And when you smile, your eyes are supposed to close a little bit. They don't.
Well, everybody's built differently.
They don't with this Scott Shannon. It's creepy. His eyes are wide open, and he smiles at the same time. All right. You want to hear their white boy song? This will end this dumb bit. Let's Go Yanks to the tune of Bon Jovi's It's My Life.
See, Bon Jovi. Now that is a white artist.
Who's singing, Todd?
Who do you think? Who always sings these?
Oh,
Mr. TP, Todd Pettengale.
He's about to prove. I swear to you, I haven't heard this song yet. I'm confident enough to say he's about to prove why he's the biggest fucking hack in Morning Zoo Radio.
Watch it. Scott and Todd is the longest running continuous New York radio show.
He's the king of something that Anthony brought to the table, the shoehorning of lyrics.
Shoehorn it in.
Meaning you push a little too many syllables in your song parody.
Yeah, and you put the accent on the wrong syllable so it fits in. That's basic shoehorning.
Here we go. Let's Go Yanks to the tune of Bon Jovi's It's My Life.
He's done it again. It's time to finish what they started.
Oh my God!
What's wrong? Todd Pettengale?
We should cut our losses and just stop right here. You know that, right?
You think so?
Yes.
Why don't we finish what we started?
Here's something: when you're doing a song parody, you should sound like the original artist. Let's start there.
At least let's start a little bit. That sounded nothing like Bon Jovi.
Oh, rumors about Shane McMahon. Speaking of wrestling,
what's the rumors?
MMA?
Oh, he's very much into MMA and boxing. Very much.
So there's two angles. Shane McMahon would not just leave the WWE. Something's going on.
Of course.
And something big is going on. Now, there's a couple of ways this could go.
I think Vince has been interested in the MMA a little bit, too. Does he start another company with Shane as the main guy? Yeah. Because Shane ain't going to do it without his dad. Or has Shane said, fuck my dad, I'm doing this on my own?
I doubt that Vince McMahon would start an MMA company. He might help Shane fund one.
Fund one.
So he'll be a silent partner.
Yeah, something more like that.
For Vince to be a silent partner.
See, Shane doesn't want to wait around for his old man to retire and become the next wrestling guy. When he can start something now. Because Shane McMahon's been on our show a lot. He's a fucking smart dude.
Yeah.
He ain't just leaving the WWE because he's bored.
And he's been
Because he's, what was the word? Bored is maybe accurate.
Gay?
No, not gay.
Oh, sorry. I just threw that in.
Yeah, but he's been.
I think he's a family man with kids.
Yeah,
of course he is.
I bet you it's an MMA thing.
He's been trying to get boxing and MMA involved with WWE in various ways for years. Like, he got Floyd Mayweather involved and all that stuff. So he's a big boxing MMA guy.
Very interesting. We'll be following that closely. All right, back to, what's his name, Todd?
Todd Pengale.
Todd doing a horrendous version.
Kind of like.
A horrendous imitation of John Bon Jovi.
Yeah.
Finish what they started.
Yankees strike first.
Gonna leave the Angels broken hearted.
12-pitch, seventh inning for Sabathia.
Man, the Bronx was rocking. It was wicked loud. Gonna take it to the series for the hometown crowd. It's so night in mid-October.
Okay, what happened?
A perfect example of the shoehorning, by the way. He added a million syllables to October and I mean, night.
It's now or never. Doesn't work with mid-October.
Going back.
Listen again.
It's so night in mid-October. We won't be happy till it's over. And we have another flag to fly.
What happened? Danny passed gas.
I'd rather hear that.
That song made Danny
quick, sample that and make a song out of it. Give it to a rap artist. He'll do something with that, Sam. That's horrendous.
Stinks.
Why are they doing
this? This guy sucks.
And I thought you were a Yankees fan.
Why would they do this?
There's your white boy song. You said there's not enough white boy songs.
Well, perhaps I can say I was absolutely wrong.
I think that was the worst one right there.
That's why I stayed there for the end. That's Scott and Todd.
And why is Todd frosting his hair? What's that about?
Stay young. Stay looking hip. Keep the girls interested.
It's a middle-aged man frosting his hair.
The girls don't know that.
They look at
head of hair and say, man, look at this young
guy. He's frosting his hair and fucking who knows what Scott's doing to his face. I would assume it's Botox or something.
Well, that's how they keep the young demo, you know? All the kids are listening to Scott and Todd, no doubt about it.
Scott has a frozen face and Todd is frosting his hair.
Yeah, man.
Ugh.
It's cool. It's 2001. People are still doing that, you know?
2001?
Is it not? Oh.
Is that when people were frosting their hair? Yeah, that was the big year for...
Yeah, it was about 2001.
The hair frosting?
Yeah. Mm.
All right. I don't even know what to say about that one. That was so bad. You can't even...
I don't know.
Whatever. No, that's just awful.
Well, the thing is, I recorded a whole Scott and Todd show, and like you'd think, like on this show, if one of us did a song parody, you'd play it once, maybe twice.
Yeah.
Later in the show, and you know that's it because you have so much stuff to get to. This song was played at least three times in a single hour.
No way.
Yeah, this song that you just heard that you could not even play once because you felt it was so bad for the medium of radio that it would be harmful to your listener base, they played three times in 1 hour.
That's how, because they feel like, you know, when they play Miley Cyrus song or something like that, if they put it in heavy rotation, and that's what makes it popular.
Yeah.
But with a parody song, not so much.
They don't put these songs on their website either because they think people probably want to steal them.
What, they're going to try to make money off that horseshit?
Other radio shows might want to latch on to the Scott and Todd parody songs.
Yeah.
Oh.
Do they put the call letters in the middle of the song so you can't fucking burn it from the,
not
from
if
the
you
radio?
Just record their radio stream.
Those, yeah.
Z100 was doing that to that Yankee song on their website.
What?
Putting the Z100. On it. That's why I had
that. No one's gonna fucking. Delusional.
Other radio shows will steal it, and
they're delusional.
And
why would you steal
their
that?
Show.
They say that that song is played in Yankee Stadium. That Z100 parody song.
All
that's
right.
What they say.
Well, there you go. There's your Jocktober for today. A little different take on the whole thing.
Yeah.
I'd rather listen to a hole and a guy that sound like they're married or something.
I actually found a show like that we could highlight on Monday.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, it's like a girl and a guy. You'd think they were married, but...
What city are we going to?
I don't know. I mean, it's the last week of Jocktober next week.
Boo. You have Let's Go, so, Mets Go? I want to hear a little
this
Let's
actually
Go.
Sounds good after listening to the rest of that crap.
This is so bad. Rock. Yes. The pendulum is swinging back. Yeah.
That's pretty good.
Got that fucking hair band sound to it. I like when they talk about players. Do it.
See, this is white people music. So corny.
This is a song they would play for a montage.
Yeah.
In the late 80s. A movie.
Hey, yeah.
This could be in Scarface.
All right, enough.
You get the point. No one is immune to the bad sports song.